Hey folks, and welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at the rounds I played at a tournament this past weekend. It was the 2023 Midsummer Meltdown, and boy, did this tournament ever live up to that name, as it was incredibly hot for both rounds. I want to say the lowest it ever was about 90 degrees Fahrenheit, so I believe that's somewhere around 32, 33 degrees Celsius for you people on the metric system, and it honestly got up to above 95 degrees, so that means it was probably pushing closer to, like, you know, 35 to 37 degrees Celsius, you know, 95 degrees Fahrenheit, and with the humidity and the heat index and everything else, it was just a super nightmare as far as heat goes. But I knew that going in, and it's all good. I stayed hydrated. You know, there was tents out there for shade. We had an umbrella for shade. So all in all, not too bad. It was also incredibly windy out in these open holes, but it wasn't like the nice cool breeze kind of windy where you felt refreshed, like, oh, thank you, breeze. No, it was like hot air blowing on you. So that was definitely a tough bit of it as well, made throwing a lot more difficult, especially because it just so happened that it was a headwind on a lot of the holes where you needed distance, so that made it pretty tricky as well. And so that was kind of some of the conditions I was dealing with. And also, I just want to, you know, not necessarily throw any excuses out there, but I kind of came into this tournament with zero expectations, and really, that's for a few different reasons. You know, first off, one, I didn't really put any practice in before this tournament. I mean, yeah, I was playing casual rounds with friends, and I practiced putting almost every day, but I didn't go out and, like, do field work, and I didn't go out and play practice rounds at these courses. I haven't played at these courses since I won the shootout tournament back in November of last year, so it's been about, you know, 8 or 9 months since I had been to these courses, and so it was a couple things I had forgotten about here and there that I just, you know, could have probably used a practice round to iron out, but, you know, it wasn't a big deal. You know, just kind of wanted to go and have a good time. Secondly, I'm also going through this 30-day cleanse thing because basically I'm just trying to have kind of a hard reset, you know, to try to get in better shape. And obviously that's going to be a long-term goal where even after the cleanse is over, I'm going to have to really focus on my fitness and my diet and things of that nature. But I'm kind of using this 30-day cleanse as kind of like just this hard reset. And so basically I'm alternating between 5 days of eating. But when I'm eating, I'm only eating around 1,100 to 1,200 calories a day. And then I'm also doing 2 days of fasting between every 5 day period of eating. So I really just kind of came into this just not even really knowing if I was going to have the stamina to be able to actually play out both rounds fully and not have any problems. And it was one of those situations where I actually did play the first round no problem, but the second round I did kind of, you know, melt down, so to speak, you know, and definitely got really tired and struggled to finish, to be quite honest with you, even though I was staying really hydrated just because, you know, I was low on calories and just didn't really have the stamina, so to speak. So again, just kind of came into it low expectations, kind of knew that I was going to be limited a little bit physically as well. But I wanted to play the tournament because, A, I wanted to get some tournament pressure, some tournament experience for later. And two, I didn't know how many more tournaments I'd get to play this year because of work schedule and stuff like that. I've been really busy with esports gigs. I've been doing some Disc Golf Pro Tour gigs now as well. And so I really just wanted to get out there and play a tournament. And this is an opportunity to do that. And I love this course. I love this property. I love Tim Clawson, who runs events here. And so I wanted to go out there and play and give it my best shot. And so, without further ado, and then I've gotten all the excuses and stuff out of the way about the weather and my cleanse and, you know, no practice and all that jazz, we will go ahead and jump into round number one, where I played at the Preserve course. All right, so we started off at the Preserve on hole number 12, the pyramid hole, about 260, 270 distance. Through my Iron Samurai 4, a little more stable MD3, and threw it pretty well. Put myself up there in a good position to grab myself a birdie shot. And really just was timid. You know, it was my first putt of the day. I don't know why I went to a straddle stance, honestly. I was just not really focused up on that one. Just a little timid, a little shaky. Next hole is just probably about 350 feet to the pin. This was a tailwind, so I threw something kind of understable, but I either gave the tailwind too much credit or just didn't give that throw enough height, or a combo of the two. And so it left me with nothing much but just kind of a jump putt layup to go ahead and tap in another par. So I'm starting off even. And as you can see, the wind is certainly blowing. You can see these branches moving around. So something that was impacting the day is we had a straight headwind on this hole, which is a little over 500 feet as a par four. So kind of a softer par four, but for AMs, you know, most of us can only throw about 300, 350 feet. And yeah, I threw something a little overstable, but not overstable enough, and the headwind just rolled this thing over. But this was definitely the miss to make because there's OB left in that wood line. There's a barbed wire fence. So missing right is the miss to make. And I still had a chance to approach here. And I just threw this one too deep and too outside. And so I wound up being deep of the pin, maybe edge of circle one or just in the circle two. So definitely a lengthy putt. Wasn't giving myself an easy one for birdie here. And once again, just a little low. And so I wound up par on that hole as well. Then we go to another hole that's about 350 feet. And again, I was dealing with that kind of head crosswind. So honestly, I just threw something overstable. It still got some flip because of the headwind. And just kind of, you know, played the hole for par, knowing that I wasn't going to be able to really reach it due to the headwind. And just an easy pitch up there to go ahead and grab my par. This hole is about 340 feet. Once again, headwind. Thought I threw a pretty good shot here. Got some turn out of it because of the headwind. And everybody thought that I was going to make it up there, but I wound up being a good bit short, probably 50 feet or so. I'm actually putting with the glow envy here because I'm putting into a headwind. Tried to just give it a light bid and, you know, really just focus on getting my par. We're now on 17, another par four, a little bit longer. Might be the longest hole on the course, actually, for us. Still dealing with that same headwind. And so this thing kind of just turns over on me, and I also just threw a little too high, got maybe a little nose up. So limited distance, but I still had about 225 to the pin. So I'm trying to throw just a putter up shot here. And I just skied it. And kind of blew an opportunity to approach for birdie there, which was really unfortunate. But I still have a window here to be able to kind of get near the basket to make sure I at least salvage par, which I am able to do. Now we're on hole 18. I would normally take this straight left lane on a forehand, but my forehand's been kind of iffy lately, and it was a headwind. So I kind of just wanted to play the gap and just play something safe and chip up and grab my par and get out of there. And I was able to do that, no problem. As you can see here, pretty easy little upshot. And a tap in for par. So still even par, just not scoring, which is a huge problem because got to be getting under par at this course to have a chance to be competitive. And now we're at hole one, a really difficult par three, and just shank this forehand. Again, my forehand's been kind of iffy lately. So I was trying not to use it, but this hole really kind of demands it. I guess I could have thrown a straight backhand, but I've always thrown forehand on this hole in the past, and that's what I figured I would try again. And unfortunately, got caught up. Second shot wasn't great really either. Didn't put enough distance on it. And so I wound up taking a bogey on this hole. So now I'm one over par. On another par four here on hole two, another chance to score. Through my glow ivy, you can see it starting to hyzer left, but it just didn't do it fast enough, so I'm kind of stuck on this right edge of woods. But luckily, I'm not deep in there, and I still have a way to get to this corner. I have a little window in front of me, so it's not the end of the world, but it kind of took birdie off the board. And so I give myself a really lengthy bid for birdie, I guess, but in all reality, I kind of had given birdie up off the tee. We got a short little crab shoot hole here, which I threw okay. Got through the gap, got up there, but still just not really giving myself easy circle one putts for birdie. Like every putt for birdie I've had so far has been well within circle two or maybe 35 feet at best. Now we got another par four here on hole number four. Didn't quite make it all the way around the corner, so I've once again taken birdie off the board just with not the greatest tee shot. And so just kind of chipping away at this one to make sure I salvage par. Which I was able to do here, as you can see, had a pretty easy tap in. Now in hole five, another kind of difficult par three, just because such a tight tunnel off the tee, but I nailed the gap perfectly there with the Iron Samurai 4. Kind of got caught behind this tree, but still had a pretty reasonable forehand upshot to get up near the pin. Did get a roll backwards, which made the putt a little bit more lengthy than I needed it to be, but I was able to grab the par here as well. Now, this is the hole I aced last year when I won the shootout tournament in November, so can lightning strike twice? Similar line. Deep of the pin. I'll actually pause the here real quick. We didn't catch this on footage, but I was basically 25 feet behind the basket, behind the tree, and had the straddle putt, and I had a dead center spit out. Like, legitimate dead center spit out. The whole car was like, what the heck? So, probably really should have had a birdie on the last hole to get back to even par after getting that bogey on hole one. But unfortunately, it just chained out, and so I took another par, and so I'm still at one over par going into hole number seven. And so I'm going to talk about this really quick because normally this hole seven, I would normally just like play a forehand over here and just play to the center of the fairway and then pitch up and grab a par. But because I knew I was one over par, and at this point, I think we only had like five holes left to play in the round, and I knew I was several strokes behind the lead, I was trying to go for the more aggressive hyzer play through this gap here. But you essentially have to be just left of this tree, and you have to have it just like on a pushing hyzer line the entire time to have a chance to get up to the green for a birdie putt. This is a pretty difficult par three, but the issue is you have to make sure you're hyzering a good bit because there's a wood line kind of on this right-hand side of the fairway that you can get easily stuck inside of if you throw too straight. And if you do that, you're basically in jail. You're pitching back out to the fairway and you're taking a bogey. So normally I would play the conservative play up this left side, just pitch up again, grab a par, move on. But I knew I needed to score here, and so I'm trying to go for the more aggressive backhand line up this right-hand side. And I just was a little off. So now I'm left with this kind of tricky 250-foot or so upshot to the green. Actually threw a shot right through the gap. But this Glow Envy just did not fade out fast enough. Just kind of kept carrying straight. This is kind of what I'm talking about. If you have something carried too straight, you get stuck in this junk over here. And I'm kind of fidgeting around for a while. So I'm trying to see if there's any type of way I can run the basket to try to save par. See if there's any little window I can maybe poke through. And I finally realized, no, there's not. And so I just wound up pitching up next to the basket. And so I'll take another bogey here to put me at two over par. Now we're on hole eight. I think it's just under 250 feet. It's kind of a basic backhand hyzer. And yeah, this Iron Samurai 4 just wasn't hyzering for me fast enough. I needed to put it on some angle. I didn't. I just kind of threw it flat. And so it just kind of flew too straight. And so now I'm stuck in some junk. Don't really have much of a putt. That tree that you see right here was like right in my way. I had to try to hyzer around it and just didn't work out. So now we're on hole nine, kind of a tricky wooded par four, not long, but just tight. Actually got kind of fortunate that this didn't go too deep on the left-hand wood line. So I kind of yanked it a little bit. Again, my forehand's been not feeling too great lately. Definitely need to put some practice in with the forehand. Threw a pretty solid second shot here. Again, I'm just looking to play this hole for par. And so at this point, I'm just kind of, you know, pitching up, playing safe, playing smart. And get it up there. And give myself a pretty easy par tap in, which will keep me at two over par, but still in a tough spot. So now we get the hole 10, right at around 200 feet. We're on my last two holes of the round at this point. Gave it a good run right next to the basket here. And so finally, I gave myself an easy birdie putt, and I'm able to cash in. So that's going to bring me back to one over par. First birdie of the tournament after parring basically the whole course except for the bogeys on 1 and 7. Get down. Then I wind up throwing this zone deep of the pin, leaving myself kind of a long putt, some windy conditions for the last hole of the round. But I grab the birdie. And so, yeah, I wound up grabbing that birdie, which was back-to-back birdies, which would put me at even par for the round. And with that, I was kind of in a multi-way tie for eighth place, four strokes off the lead going into round number two. The footage for round number two will be up tomorrow. I appreciate all of you folks for tuning in. I know this was kind of some mediocre golf, but that's what you normally get here. You guys know what you're in for. I'm not any kind of crazy top pro or anything like that. So anyway, I hope that you folks enjoyed the content. If you did, please go ahead and follow and subscribe. We actually did hit 1,000 subscribers there for a moment. I was going to do like a little 1,000 subscriber kind of celebration thing, but then I wound up dropping back down to 999 subscribers, and I think now I'm at 998. So I never got to have like that 1,000 subscriber moment. Really, or it only lasted for like a day and then it knocked back down. So I think I'm gonna have to kind of wait until maybe I get to like kind of that 1,010 subscriber mark or something, where I feel kind of safe that it's gonna stick at 1,000 and I'm not gonna lose subs, and then maybe I'll do a special video for 1,000 subscribers, something like that. But either way, we're certainly very close. We were actually there very briefly, and then unfortunately we kind of dropped back down. So yeah, if you could, and if you're not already, please go ahead and give subscribe, you know, comment, like, help feed the algorithm, share with some friends, you know, do the things to help me out, if you don't mind. I appreciate you. But anyway, be on the lookout for round two coming out real soon. Thanks again, and see you soon.